Yo, what it do? It's your boy MTZ King, and I'm back on your screen. What's good? I hope everybody has a great, amazing, blessed Tuesday. Today's October the 6th, and in just about 4 hours, I will be in the hospital. Right now, it's already 2 o'clock. So yeah, like in 4 hours. Well, I'm not even in like three and a half some hours. I'll be leaving to the hospital because I have to be there. I have to be at that floor right by 7. The floor that I'm gonna be on. Like I told you on yesterday's video, yes, I've been feeling like sad and whatnot, you know, because I'm so used to, like, my mom and my little brother taking care of me, and I got so, when I seen my baby brother cry, earlier, which was actually yesterday, you could say, because it was right before, like, 9 o'clock, because that's the time he usually goes to sleep. Even he does virtual, he still goes to sleep at that time, you know, and he started crying. And just the bond that me and him have is like this. Ever since he was a baby, you know, I had that bond with him. And, you know, I went in there, I hugged him, and I told him it was going to be okay. And as bad as I wanted to cry, I just knew I had to be strong for him. And I told him, you know, it's going to be okay. So what I did, I drew him on. For those of you that are familiar with gaming, there is a game called Among Us. He's so into that game. He's been so into that game for the last couple of months. And I drew him one of the little Among Us characters, which is like the police officer. So I wrote him a note. And I actually put it on his desk because his desk is in my room with his laptop. So it's on top of the laptop. So in the morning, of course, I'm going to see him before I leave. But I'm not going to tell him it's there until he comes for school. And he will see that it's on there. And he'll be able to read it before he starts his school. But I did tell him, you know, not to worry. That I'll be back home sooner, hopefully. And even though he talks a lot, like, I'm going to miss him, you know. Or my little brother can talk and talk and talk and talk. He's a little parrot. But I love him with all my heart. And, you know, I did pray with my mom. And I just was trying not to get emotional. My mom wanted to say a prayer, but I knew she said the prayer, she was gonna start crying, and I just didn't want that. I don't want them to. I need somebody to be strong for me. You know what I'm saying? And I just want them to be strong for me. Like I said, I'm just gonna be down the street from them, but it does suck that there's no visitations. There's only one person allowed, but if that person goes with me, they have to go with me right early in the morning when I show up, because I believe they're testing whoever is going to be staying with the patient or whatever, because you cannot be going in and out. Like, say for instance, if my mom would have went in the morning, she could not come back home and go back. They're not allowing that. That once you're there, you have to be there until they release me, you know. So you know, it's been emotional for me, but you know, I thank God that, you know, they're going to test me. I'm praying to God the COVID test comes back negative. So, you know, I could get answers to these seizures and get treated on the right treatment that I need to be get treated for. And, you know, because it sucks, like I said, you know, a lot of people may think that, oh, just because I'm, you know, walking and this and this and that, you know, that I'm in the best health. I'm not in the best health, because if I was, I wouldn't be going through all this. In total seizures, I then have had 407 now seizures, and that's just too much for that, you know. That's just past the damn borderline. So I need, you know, answers. But to my little brother, no, just know that I love you with all my heart. I love you to the moon and back. And just remember, God got me, and I'll see you soon. And I'm gonna miss you, but you know you could call me whenever you want. Same thing to my mom, you know, I love you, mom. Thanks to both of you for taking care of me. And you know, it's only for the best, and I am gonna miss you. But you know, these seizures could get worse, and that's what I don't want. Seizures are very dangerous. You could die from them, and I don't want to die from a seizure. So yeah. But anyways, though, I will see y'all. I'll pick up the vlog in a little bit when I start getting ready and stuff, when I head out. But thanks to everybody who's been sending me prayers. I appreciate you all. It means a lot to me. But I will catch y'all in the morning, though. What up, squad? I'm in the hospital already. Waiting for them to come in here. But I will catch y'all in a bit, though. Chill. Hurts my heart to see you cry. I know it's dark, this part of life. Oh, it finds us all. We're too small to stop the rain. Oh, but when it rains, I will stay. This video is probably not gonna be long, this vlog, but I will catch y'all in a little bit though. Chill. Yo, what it do? I hope everybody had a great, amazing day. Don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, join the team, join the squad. I will explain to y'all a lot more when I get home, and I don't know exactly when that's gonna be. But yeah. Thanks for all the prayers. It means a lot to me. Like I said to my baby brother, I love you, man, with all my heart. And hopefully I get home soon. And I will see y'all hopefully tomorrow. With that being said, much love. Oh, thanks to my bro, Adon, for bringing me and dropping me off. I really appreciate it. Much love, bro. Thanks so much. Till to everybody who's been there for me. I appreciate you. With that being said, I'm out. Chill.